grand! So many doors! The path still appears to travel onwards behind a large gate, but there are forks in this path. An opportunity to travel, see the universe, go along any path I desire. All this traveling, though, I would like a traveling companion. Someone to watch over me, help decide where to go, watch my back, keep me company. Oh, but that's just silliness. I don't really need anyone. I'm a god. This world has rules, clearly. For one, I cannot walk through walls, which is disturbing. You'd think if I was a god, I could do what I wished. For the most part, I don't appear to be in control. Perhaps my subconscious is keeping the world in shape. Subconscious. A powerful part of mind, all along unobserved, subtle. I wonder what resides in this subconscious. Those thoughts that I'm not aware of. Not all of my decisions are wisely made under the full power of cognition. Some decisions are made outside of the conscious self. I seem to observe a lot of my actions with little or no control over them. I must still own these actions. If knowledge is in the mind, to be alone is to experience all of knowledge. All the substance of knowledge exists within mind. Therefore, to suppose another, whose mind was unknowable or transient, would suppose a world in which all knowing was an impossibility. So it follows that being alone serves as a proof of my deity. In this way, it is a comfort to me that I am alone. Others would be a difficult problem. A stairway to heaven made of fool's gold. Being alone is important. If one does not hear both parts of a conversation, one cannot have a full idea of what is discussed. To be alone is to know the whole story. But still, this world seems to attempt to communicate something. The world is filled with part conversation. The writings on the walls, the walls themselves. Let there be yet more light! Being alone can serve as a comfort. If there's no one, no one can hurt you. But perhaps that's a bleak outlook. There must be joy that comes from others. Praise? They can offer praise. As a god, praise is something I can relate to. Not enough praise at the moment. Worship wouldn't go amiss. But if there were others, they might attempt to belittle me. Bring me down to improve their own relative status. Accuse me of pride, narcissism, pretentiousness, or grandiose self-referential commentary. Nonsense. Pretension implies there is a lack of thought. The pretense of thought. I've thought long and hard about how brilliant I am. Why can I be surprised? If I'm all-knowing, then I should know all. Perhaps there is a moment when knowledge is created. Sometimes when I ask these questions, I wish there was a response. Wish there was someone out there listening to me, hearing these words. But how could they tell me even if they were listening? I've never heard their voice. If a voice came down from the sky to talk to me, I'd probably think I was crazy. But in case anyone's listening, I have a surplus of gold. If you'd like to pop by my universe, I could give you some. Friendship for gold? Straight up trade? It doesn't take a genius to see that I am a genius. Comparative statements are somewhat redundant when you're the lone wanderer of the universe. I think I'd like a goddess to share this with. We could walk around and talk about gold, perhaps waste away the time discussing how brilliant I am. She could bask in my intellect and compliment me on my immense wealth. Perhaps she'd look like me too. Obviously she couldn't be as handsome, that would be unthinkable. Could I create a goddess more majestic than myself? Could I create a rock that I couldn't lift? Well, apparently I can create doors I cannot open. What does a goddess do, though? Quite clearly, I'm busy doing all this god stuff. Walking about, thinking about stuff, solving problems, inventing problems to solve. Would she be my helper, or off doing her own thing? I'm a pretty big deal. If I had a goddess, I'd assume she'd want to be around me most of the time. But I feel like I'm too busy with all these challenges to possibly give her all of my attention. I mean, to be fair, it's likely to destroy her given my godlike intensity. Maybe I'd make her in my image. That would be amazing! Two of me! Oh, we'd have so much in common! I'd quite like her to be lively. First, she'd have to be alive. Being alive is somewhat a prerequisite for being lively. Not created life yet. through a glass dimly, not knowing as I should know. Obsession with light here. I'm done here. The sad thing about being a god is the crushing loneliness. I don't really feel I have an equal. This wall, for instance. And don't get me wrong, he's a smart-looking wall. I enjoy being around him, but he has little of interesting conversation. Very flat personality. Like the bridge from earlier. Very anthropomorphized. I love giant machines. The bigger the machine, the better. This is my idea of heaven. There's something about a giant machine that screams godlike. Me and my machines, animated, as if alive, but really just acting inside a closed system. They give the impression they are full of life, but they are just wheels and cogs that turn in time. Ticking, clicking, and clacking contraptions. Thank you. Still, no companion. What if it's all a joke, this whole world? A grand joke of which I am the punchline. What if someone stands looking on, grinning atop their high horse? An elevated perspective makes it easy to look down. What if someone distant and unknowable thank you. a state change on observation. Things in this world can change. Apparently between only two states though, on and off. Hopefully not indicative of my state of mind. Binary, between two extremes, two poles if you will. But why does the world change between a few states? Changes only seem to occur in small degrees. Why? Why is the world quantized? It confuses me that there's a limited amount of states in this world. I think that there would be an infinite amount. Why would there need to be a limit unless there was a constraint? And why would there be a constraint? I sure hope it's due to incomprehensible macro-level relationships rather than the overwhelming simplicity of a system. That is a nightmare which I could not face. The implication would be clear. A wooden boy given the breath of life. Thank you. continuous makes more sense than discrete, surely. All ideas are continuous, but the mechanics discrete. Nonsense, clearly nonsense. The location of each item in the world is only accurate to a binary exponent width of 8 bits. Why? And still, it can only be observed by a keen eye for infinitesimal phenomena. Planck's constant, the universe's machine epsilon. Oh, what am I even saying? Paranoia! Paranoia!